Thought about our graduating seniors this week as I saw the news that Harvard University and Massachusetts Institute of Technology, MIT, have announced this week they combined their online course offerings. And so they're going to be making available many, if not most, of their courses online for free to anybody in the world who wants to take the course. If you take the course and pass it, you'll get a certificate, not a diploma. But it will be the same course as the students take, and you'll be graded in the same way. And it signals a shift in the form of the way education is delivered. Really signals the beginning of a movement in that direction, already begun, but this, I don't know, seems like an official announcement that we're moving in a new direction. We find in life that forms change, whether in education, whether in nature, whether in our spiritual lives. Forms change, but our values sustain us in times of change. Keep that in mind as we turn to the reading for this morning, the Gospel according to John, chapter 15, verses 1 through 8, where Jesus is teaching and using a figure of speech to describe his relationship with his disciples, which would include you and me. Listen for what the Spirit is saying to the church. Jesus says, "I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine grower. He removes every branch in me that bears no fruit. Every branch that bears fruit, he prunes to make it bear more fruit. You have already been cleansed by the word that I have spoken to you. Abide in me as I abide in you. Just as the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Those who abide in me and I in them bear much fruit. Because apart from me, you can do nothing. Whoever does not abide in me is thrown away like a branch and withers. Such branches are gathered, thrown into the fire, and burned. If you abide in me, and my words abide in you, ask for whatever you wish, and it will be done for you. My Father is glorified by this, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples." The word of the Lord for us today. Thanks be to God. In silence, let us pray to the Lord. Amen. I mentioned about the edX project of putting all the courses online for Harvard and MIT. And the way that signifies that forms of education change. There was another project that was taken on about 5 years ago by Nicholas Negroponte, who was from MIT also. And his project was called One Laptop per Child. The vision was to provide a $100 laptop that would be made available to children in developing countries so that they could have access to the internet, and it also had a wind-up energy battery on it so that they wouldn't have to worry about whether or not they had electricity where they lived. And they worked on that, and they worked on that, and they never could get it below $150. In the meantime, cell phone, smartphone technology developed to such an extent that now in India they're selling smartphones, some of them for $10 each. And so, because Nicholas Negroponte thought that education for children had to occur in the form of a laptop, because that's the form it was in at that time, he missed the boat on this new form, which is the smartphone. The form changes, but the content remains the same. As our graduating seniors leave their high school, they go into a big transition because they have been seniors at their high school. They've been the big man on campus, let's say, the seniors, and they go to the college in the fall in a new place, and they start out as freshmen. It's a different role that you play, but you're still within the education system. The forms or roles that we play may change, but our values sustain us during times of change. These kinds of changes in forms are happening, of course, with jobs, as so many different industries are facing layoffs and job shortages around the country, as more and more work becomes collaboration. We see this online with Wikipedia, a million people or more collaborating and make this encyclopedia that now has made the Encyclopedia Britannica stop printing their encyclopedia. They're just going to put theirs online. All of these changes in form do not change our values. There was a spiritual master. He was a Hindu spiritual master. And one of his disciples really took a fondness for him and decided he was going to make it his job to feed the master every day. And so he would make food for him. And the disciple would not eat until the master came. And the problem was the master was unpredictable as to when he would come. He might come sometime at 9 a.m., he might come sometime at 4 p.m., might come sometime at midnight. And the disciples sitting around waiting until he comes before he eats. Well, the master developed a fondness for the disciple after many months of seeing his dedication. He said, "Listen, I'll tell you what. I will come to your house and eat next time." And so the disciple said, "Oh, that's fantastic. I will be honored to have you." And so the disciple went home and he cooked a very nice meal. And when the appointed time came, the master was not there. He did notice a dog over by the table, which was odd, and so he tried to run the dog out, and the dog didn't want to leave, and so he had to get angry with the dog and had to force the dog out of the house finally, and the master never showed up. And so the next time the disciple went and saw the master at the master's house, the master was sitting there crying. And the disciple said, What's going on? You said you were going to come to my house and eat. You never came." And the master, through his tears, said, "Oh, yes, I came. I came to your house. And you kicked me out." The disciple said, "What are you talking about? You never came to my house." He said, "Yes, I came to your house. I came to your house in the form of a dog." The master said, "Don't ever put too much trust in any particular form of manifestation. We like to have things the way we've always had them. We don't like to be surprised. We don't like things given to us in a new form, especially when it comes to our faith in God, our religion. And yet even our faith and our religion is in a time of rapid change. In times of change, forms may change, but our values do not change. If you think about Jesus' illustration here of the vine, I am the vine, my Father's the vine grower. If you think about what happens on a vine, a little bulb comes up, a little leaf eventually becomes a grape, very different from what it started out as. And human beings find over time, if you take the grapes and you step on them and get them all mashed up and you put them aside for a while, after a while you can drink them and they taste really good and they make you feel good. They become wine. The form changes, but the essence remains. The essence being the connection with the source, the light, God. We have bread, we have wine for communion today. Symbolic to us of the interchange that we seek within. We seek Christ to be within us and to be expressed in our lives. So forms change. Forms in nature, forms in our jobs, forms in our spiritual lives, forms in education, but our values remain the same. And what are our values? Our values, according to Jesus, is to bear much fruit. And the fruit Jesus is talking about is the fruit of the Spirit. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, gentleness, self-control. That is what we are called to bear in our life. So often we get confused when we're 18 years old or when we're 50 years old about what is the difference between our calling and our job. A job is what you do to make a living. A calling is what you do to make a life. Your job can pay your bills, but your calling is what gives you life. This is what God put you here to do. So I encourage our graduates, I encourage us all, find our calling. Find ways that we as individuals, we as a congregation, can provide new opportunities to develop people, to love people, and to live our lives connected to the vine. This is what Jesus meant when he said, I am the true vine, and you are the branches.